One thing that has definitely changed is, as you see, we have people in our parking lot, so our lobby is completely empty. So we have techs who are running back and forth all day. So they come out and they will talk to the client, they will take the patient inside and do the exam, and then convey information from the veterinarian back to the client. So they're running back and forth. And then there's the receptionists who are answering, now it's between 200 and 300 phone calls a day, in addition to answering the calls from the clients who are waiting, or the adoption applicants who are waiting for their appointments that they have. So there is a lot of running around and back and forth. We just recently were able to hire two vet techs back, and add another veterinarian, so another surgeon, which has been wonderful because our surgeries were really limited in the beginning. They wanted us to hold off on anything that wasn't essential, because we didn't know what medications and PPE may be needed for human hospitals. So that's had a huge impact, I think. I can personally say that I know that our dog intake numbers are up from last year. Now, can I say what directly causes that? I don't know, but I know that a lot more people are moving, and some of it I do know just from the people I've spoken with. It is due to COVID, that they've had to downsize or just relocate, move in with family, and they may not be able to keep their dog. I think it's similar to that for the cats. I cannot speak 100%. I'm not the feline shelter director. But that's definitely an impact that we've had. One positive impact is we've had a lot of people who know that they don't have time when they're working full time to have a dog, because the dog is a huge commitment, but they have opened their homes to fostering, which has been absolutely fantastic. That's led to several adoptions and just meeting some new people in the community and people who are as passionate about cats and dogs as we are.